Good morning, one and all. In this video lesson, we are mainly going to discuss regarding the torque equation of PMMC meter. In the last video lesson, we have started our discussion regarding the construction and working of different meters. So in that, we have mainly focused on the different types of instruments which are used as ammeters and voltmeters, and we have also seen regarding the construction and working of PMMC meter, permanent magnet moving coil meter. As the name indicates, the magnets are fixed, permanent magnet moving coil, a coil will be rotating. So whenever the coil is rotating in magnetic field created by permanent magnets, it produces a mechanical force. Because of that mechanical force, the coil will try to rotate. So coil is carrying current that is placed in magnetic field. Because of that, according to Lorentz's law, it will experience a mechanical force. Because of that, it will rotate. So that rotation will be deflected the pointer, and the pointer will move on the scale according to the measurement. This is how the permanent magnet moving coil meter will rotate, will operate. Now we are going to see regarding the amount of deflecting torque produced because of this PMMC meter in this today's video lesson. In this today's video lesson, we are going to derive the expression for deflecting torque produced by PMMC meter. So we are going to derive the torque equation of the PMMC meter, and based on the torque equation we will solve simple problems on PMMC meter. So this is regarding the PMMC meter. So this is a PMMC meter. It mainly consisting of this permanent magnet, U-shaped permanent magnet. And in this permanent magnet, we are placing a core. On this, we are placing one rectangular aluminium frame. On this frame, we have placed the coil. On this rectangular aluminium frame, we have placed the coil. For this, the core will be made up of in the form of a cylindrical structure. For this structure, spindle is attached. And the spindle to spiral springs are connected. So this is lower control spring and this is upper control spring. This is the core of the cylindrical core. These are the permanent magnets, this one and this one. And this is the moving coil, and for this spindle a pointer is attached. This is the steel ring. So these are the different parts. so this magnetic field will be produced because of the permanent magnets. On this permanent magnets, whenever we are sending the current through the coil, current will be flowing from spiral springs through coil, and again it will be going outside. Whenever current is flowing through the coil, it is placed in a magnetic field, it will experience a mechanical force, it will try to rotate. So this is the working of the PMMC meter. So this deflection will rotate the spindle, and as the spindle is rotates, the pointer will move on the scale. So in the last class we have seen the construction and working of PMMC meter in detail. In the last class we have discussed. So this is the two-dimensional view of a PMMC meter. It will be consisting of these permanent magnets, and these are placed in a moving coil type meter, and here this is the rectangular aluminium frame. On this the coil will be placed. For this the spindle will be attached. On this the springs will be placed, and for this spindle a pointer is attached. This pointer will be moving on a dial. Now the operating principle of PMMC meter. A lightweight coil or copper wire is suspended in the field of the permanent magnet. A lightweight coil or a copper wire is suspended in the field of permanent magnet. The current flows in the wire produces a magnetic field by the coil, which interacts with the field from the magnet. And the coil will rotate. So this is the photograph of PMMC meter. So if you open the PMMC meter, inside the cover it will be look like. So here this is external shield, steel ring. This is external steel ring, and this is the permanent magnet. This is the moving coil. This is the control spring. This is a pointer. Just now we have seen the same representation, and this is for arrangement. So whenever the pointer is reflecting, again we have to bring back to zero. So it is an arrangement for zero balance of the pointer. So the permanent magnet moving coil, PMMC meter mainly consists of these parts. Moving coil, magnet system, control spring, damping, and pointer and scale. So these are the important points existing in a PMMC meter. It consisting of a magnet. So in between magnets, so we are placing the moving coil. And a control spring. Control spring is attached to spindle, and a damping force. So that is produced due to aluminium former, and a pointer and scale. The pointer will be attached to spindle, and it is moving on a scale. So PMMC meter, we will see some important points. PMMC meter is the most accurate type of DC measurements. PMMC meter also referred to as D-arsenal moving meter. The PMMC instrument can be used as ammeter and voltmeter. So this figure shows the representation of PMMC meter. Here we are having two poles, and this actually it is 2D view. Here we are having a cylindrical core to produce the radial magnetic field. On this core we have placed the aluminium former, rectangular aluminium former. On this we have placed the winding. So for this a pointer will be attached, spindle, and it is moving on a scale. So this is a fixed cylindrical core, and this is for producing radial magnetic field. These are the two permanent magnets, and these should be chosen such that it should have more flux density. More flux density should be more. So because of that, these poles are made up of Alnico or Alcomax material. And on this spindle, springs will be made. Springs will be attached. Those springs will be made up of fast power branch material. It consists of a rectangular coil wound on a soft iron core, which is suspended on the field of permanent magnet. The rectangular coil is mounted on jewel bearings so that it is forced to move. An aluminium pointer is attached to the moving coil. When the coil rotates, the pointer moves on a graduated scale. Two springs are attached to the coil assembly, one at the top and other at the bottom. The deflection type instruments, three operating forces are required for operating deflection type instruments. We require three forces, as we discussed in the earlier classes, and they are deflecting force, controlling force, and the damping force. So the deflecting force will be whenever the current flows in the coil, the magnetic flux is produced. This electromagnetic flux interacts with the flux due to permanent magnets. A torque is called a deflecting torque is produced. As a result, the coil starts rotating, and along with it, a pointer is also moves over the scale. Now we are going to derive the expression for deflecting torque developed by PMMC meter. So we will assume TD. TD will represent the deflecting torque, and TC will represent the controlling torque. Theta is the angle of deflection. K is the spring constant, and B is the width of the coil. L is the length of coil. N is the number of turns. I represents current flowing through the coil. P represents flux density, and A represents the area of coil. So assume we have placed having length L and the area A, coil in magnetic field which is having flux density capital B, and the coil is having n number of turns, and if we send current of I amperes, then it is producing a deflecting torque of TD. And because of its deflection, due to spiral springs, it is producing a controlling torque of TC, and the angle of deflection we are assuming as theta, and the spring constant is K. The width of the coil we are assuming B. So length of the coil is L, the width of the coil is B. So in that case, we will derive the expression. So according to Lorentz's law, whenever the current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it will experience a mechanical force. So that mechanical force is given by F equal to BIL sin theta. F equal to BIL sin theta. If we produce radial field then the force will be maximum. For that we are using cylindrical core. So theta is equal to 90 degrees. In that case, sine theta, so sine 90 will be equal to 1. Then the net force will be given as F equal to BIL, BIL newtons meters. Force F equal to BIL newtons. And if the coil is having n number of turns, then the net force developed by the coil will be equal to F equal to BIL into n. So the net force developed will be equal to F equal to n into B into I into L newtons. Okay. Now the torque developed, the net torque developed will be given as TD is equal to F into perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance, so that is the width. So deflecting torque will be equal to NBIL into B. NBIL into B, where L and B are the length and width of the coil, and L into B will be the area, area of cross section. The deflecting torque produced will be equal to BINA. BINA. So it is given as TD equal to BANI. This deflecting torque will be directly proportional to the current, current which is flowing through the coil. So TD is directly proportional to capital I. Deflecting torque is directly proportional to current which is flowing through the coil. Now we are going to discuss the advantages of this PMMC meter. So in this PMMC meter, the torque to weight ratio is very high and the power consumption is very less. As we are using control method, control torque we are producing due to springs, the scale is uniform. And here we are using eddy current damping. The damping is very effective. That means the pointer will quickly come into the final position. So the oscillations produced will be very minimum. Since operating field is very strong, the effect of stray field is negligible. So we are using permanent magnets. Is there any external stray magnetic fields? Unwanted magnetic fields will not affect the operating of the instrument. And the range of instrument can be extended. So these are the main advantages. And coming to disadvantages, this PMMC meter will be used only for DC. It is only used for direct current measurement. And the cost of instrument is high. And errors produced due to aging effect of PMMC meter. So once the meter is becoming older one, the errors will become present in the instrument. Friction and temperature errors are present in the instrument. And these PMMC meters are mainly used in ammeters, galvanometers, ohmmeters, voltmeters. Actually, the basic meter will be same, but according to the requirement, we are converting into either ammeter or voltmeter or ohmmeter, galvanometer. So, according to the requirement, we are using the meter in practical applications. Now let us solve simple problems on the deflecting torque of the PMMC instrument. A coil of a PMMC instrument having 60 turns on a former that is 18 mm wide, the effective length of conductor being 25 mm, it moves in a uniform field of flux density 0.5 Tesla. The control spring constant is 1.5 into 10 power minus 6 newton meters per degree. Calculate the current required to produce a deflection of 100 degrees. So here, so the number of turns are 60. Rectangular form, that is of 18 mm wide. The effective length on conductor is 25 mm. So here area will be 25 mm into 18 mm. The uniform field of flux density B is equal to 0.5 Tesla and the spring constant is 1.5 into 10 power minus 6 newton meter per degree. And here the theta is 100 degrees. 100 degrees. Now we need to calculate the amount of current which is flowing through the coil. So number of turns equal to 60 and area of cross section will be equal to length 25 mm into width 18 mm. The magnetic field flux density B is equal to 0.5 Tesla and the spring constant K is equal to 1.5 into 10 power minus 6 newton meter per degree. So from this given data, the deflecting torque produced on the coil will be equal to TD. TD will be equal to BIL NB. So actually we have derived the expression TD is equal to NBIA. NBIA, here area directly not given. So that area we are writing as L into B. So now we will derive the expression TD as 0.5 into, we don't know the current which is flowing through the coil. So write I, length and width they have given as 25 mm and 18 mm and number of turns are 60. So you substitute in this. And at final deflecting position, we know the deflection torque has to be equal to the controlling torque, and the controlling torque exerted by the springs will be given as TC is equal to KS into theta, where KS is the spring constant, it is given as 1.5 into 10 power minus 6 and theta is 100. So at the final deflecting position, we know TD is equal to TC. So at equilibrium position, deflecting torque is equal to controlling torque. So this 0.5 into I into 18 mm into 25 mm into 60 will be equal to 1.5 into 10 power minus 6 into 100. So from this, if we calculate the current, then we will get as 11.11 milliamperes. So we will see once again. So from the given data, they have given the number of turns, area of cross section as 25 mm into 18 mm, the magnetic flux density 0.5 Tesla, spring constant 1.5 into 10 power minus 6. And they have given angle of deflection as 100 degrees. Now we required the value of current which is flowing through the coil. So our interest is to calculate current flowing through the coil. Okay. So to calculate current, we require two things. We need to calculate the deflecting torque produced by the instrument, and we need to calculate control torque produced by the instrument. So we know at final deflecting position, at equilibrium condition, this TD will be equal to TC. deflecting torque is equal to controlling torque. So from this condition you calculate the value of current flowing through the coil. If you want, please you can make a note. Very important, you have to note down the formulas. The deflecting torque TD will be equal to NBIA, where A is the area of cross section, I is the current flowing through the coil, B is the flux density, N is the number of turns. And for PMMC meter, this controlling torque will be equal to Ks into theta, where Ks is the spring constant. Theta is the angle of deflection. So in this final deflecting position, current will be equal to 11.11 milliamperes. Please you make a note, then we will discuss some more problems. So we will switch over to next problem. A PMMC instrument has a coil of dimensions 15 mm by 12 mm. The flux density in the air gap is 1.8 into 10 power minus 3 Weber per meter square. And the spring constant is 0.14 into 10 power minus 6 Newton meters per radians. Determine the number of turns required to produce an angular deflection of 90 degrees and the current of 5 milliamperes is flowing through the coil. I repeat, PMMC meter having area of cross section 15 mm by 12 mm and the flux density 1.8 into 10 power minus 3 Weber per meter square. Spring constant 0.14 into 10 power minus 6. Now our intention is to calculate the number of turns when the angle of deflection is 90 degrees and current flowing through the coil is 5 milliamperes. So we require how many number of turns of coil we need to place on the rectangular frame. So this thing we need to calculate. Okay, so for that, similarly we need to calculate the deflecting torque and the controlling torque, and at equilibrium position we need to equate both the things TD and TC, and we have to calculate the number of turns. Now the total deflecting torque exerted on a coil will be equal to TD is equal to BIL into N into B. So it is equal to 1.8 into 10 power minus 3, 5 into 10 power minus 3, the current 5 milliamperes, and the area of cross section as 15 mm by 12 mm. So mm millimeter, so that is equal to 10 power minus 3 meters, and N is the number of turns. So TD will be equal to 1.8 into 10 power minus 3, 5 into 10 power minus 3 into 15 into 10 power minus 3 into 12 into 10 power minus 3 into N.
So our intention is to find out n. N is not given. So this we'll get by solving. And the controlling torque produced by the springs will be given as TC is equal to KS into 60 degrees. KS into, so what is the angle of deflection? It is 90 degrees. KS into 90 degrees. So 90 into pi by 60. KS is given as 0.14 into 10 power minus 6 into 90 into pi by 180. From this equilibrium position, we will get the number of turns. Number of turns as 136 turns. Now we will solve one more problem. In a moving coil instrument, the coil is wound with 50 turns in square section former of mean length 4 cm long each side. The coil charge is in a uniform radial field of 0.08 Weber per meter square. Find the torque produced in the coil. So this is simple problem. Here they have given the number of turns as 50 and it is a square cross section. So the length is given as 4 centimeters and the area will be given as square of side. So 4 centimeters into 4 centimeters and the flux density they have given as 0.08 Weber per meter square. Okay. Now we will calculate the deflecting torque. The deflecting torque produced will be given as TD. TD is equal to the force into width of the coil, where the force is given as BIL. Into width into number of turns. NBIL into width of the coil. So as the coil is placed on a rectangular cross section field, the section is having in the form of square, then the width is also equal to length, then the net torque will be equal to NBIL square Newton meters. NBIL square Newton meters. Now the torque produced will be equal to 50 into 0.08 into 10 in 10 power minus 3 into 0.04 whole square. Now net deflecting torque produced will be calculated as 6.4 into 10 power minus 4 Newton meters. One more problem. The moving coil of a meter has 100 turns and the width of 3 cm and the depth of 4 cm is placed in a uniform radial field of 60 Weber per meter square. Find the deflecting torque of a coil when it is carrying 1.5 milliamperes. So the number of turns is equal to 100, depth 4 cm and the current flowing is 1.5 milliamperes. And width will be 3 centimeters. Flux density P is equal to 60 Weber per meter square. Now we need to calculate the deflecting torque. To calculate deflecting torque, the formula is NBIA. Here A is the area of coil. It is given as length into width. So here the length into width is calculated as A is equal to 3 centimeters into 4 centimeters. So we will get as 0.0012 square meters. We substitute in the expression deflecting torque TD. TD is equal to NBIA. NBIA. So where A is the area of cross section, I is the current flowing, B is the flux density, N is the number of turns. With that, we will get the deflecting torque. Sometimes they won't give the value of current direct, so they will give the amount of voltage produced and the resistance of the coil. So with that you calculate current value and you solve the remaining. So these are the few sample problems on how we are calculating the deflecting torque produced by the pointer of a PMMC meter. Now we will see some important questionnaire on the PMMC meter. Till now we have seen regarding the operating principle of PMMC meter is Lorentz's law. Whenever a current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it will experience a force, and the direction of force will be given according to Fleming's left hand rule. Stretch your forefinger, middle finger, thumb finger of your left hand such that forefinger, middle finger, thumb finger of left hand such that one is perpendicular to another. Then if the forefinger indicates the direction of magnetic field, forefinger indicates direction of magnetic field, and the middle finger indicates direction of current in the conductor, middle finger indicates direction of current, and then the remaining thumb finger indicates the direction of motion of conductor. Thumb finger indicates motion of the conductor. So according to that we are producing the mechanical force, and the force will be given as F equal to BIL sin theta. So in PMMC meter we are producing radial magnetic field for getting maximum deflecting torque. So the deflecting torque we have calculated as TD is equal to NBIA Newton meters, and in PMMC meter we are using spring control method, and that springs will be producing controlling torque. As we are using spring control method, the scale which is used in PMMC meter is uniform scale, as the angle of reflection is directly proportional to current flowing through the coil. Theta is directly proportional to I. Okay, so with this we will see some important questions. What is the function of PMMC meter? For what purpose we are using this meter? So this meter will be used to measure current and voltage. We are measuring only direct current quantities. PMMC meter will be used to measure the direct current and direct voltage. DC current and DC voltage. Why PMMC does not use it for AC? So just now we discussed PMMC meter will be used only for measuring direct current quantities. It is not used for AC because these instruments measures average value, and the average value of AC quantity is zero. Because the average value is zero, the pointer does not move. It will stay at zero. What is the working principle of PMMC meter? So it is working on Lorentz's principle. So that is the electromagnetic effect. Whenever the current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it will experience a mechanical force. Now we will solve some multiple choice questions on this PMMC meter. The term artificial aging in instrument is associated with option A, springs, option B, permanent magnets, option C, control torque, option D, damping. So this aging is associated with the permanent magnets. Once the machine is becoming older, the values which you are getting is not perfect one, because the magnetic field produced will be reduces because of aging of permanent magnets. It loses their magnetic property. The moving iron and PMMC instruments can be distinguished from each other by looking at option A, pointer, option B, terminal size, option C, scale, option D, scale range. Actually, the scale of PMMC meter is uniform. And coming to moving iron instruments, the scale is crampered scale. So depending on the type of controlling torque, so here the distinction is with respect to scale, option C. The disadvantage of PMMC is high power consumption. Option B, high cost relative to moving iron instrument. Low torque weight ratio, the absence of effective and efficient eddy current damping, all of the above. So here the option is B. So it is having high cost. Compared to MI instruments, the PMMC meters are having higher cost. A sinusoidal voltage of 1V RMS value at 10 Hz is applied across two terminals of a PMMC type voltmeter. What is the deflection of pointer? So whenever we are applying AC, pointer won't move. So the deflection is 0 volts. Option A, 0 volts. Option B, 1 volt. Option C, square root of 2. Option D, the pointer will oscillate around 0 volts. So I think it is option D. And most of the important specifications, the most important specification of instrument is option A, resolution, option B, reproducibility, option C, range, option D, sensitivity. So for an instrument, the important specification is range, at what range it is operating. So whenever we are selecting a meter for a quantity measurement, we have to select a proper range. All are important, and in that range is most important. The PMMC instrument will read option A, average value, option B, RMS value, option C, both, option D, none. Actually, this PMMC meter will read average values, option A. A PMMC instrument will read for the following input. I is equal to 2 plus 4 sine 3140 amperes. So it is measuring current, in that it is measuring only DC quantities. So actually it is 2 amperes, option A. Option B 46 amperes, option C 4 amperes, option D 2.83. So option A is the answer, 2 amperes. Next, the scale of PMMC instrument is option A linear, option B non-linear, option C bidirectional, option D logarithmic. So the tail scale is a linear scale. Linear scale, as we are using spring control method, the theta is directly proportional to current. So linear scale. In PMMC instrument, the controlling torque is provided by option A gravity control method, option B spring control method, option C cylindrical core, option D no controlling torque. So in this we are using spiral springs, so that will produce controlling torque. So for this, the answer is option B. Option B, spring control torque. Next one, in PMMC instrument, the eddy current damping is provided by. Option A, spring. Option B, permanent magnets. Option C, aluminium base. Option D, cylindrical core. So here we are using aluminium base, so this will produce the eddy current damping. Last one, PMMC instrument, the permanent magnets are made up of, very important in competitive exams, frequently they are asking this question. Option A alnico, option B nickel, option C cobalt, option D steel. Very important, it will be made up of alnico. Alnico, sometimes they make you as alcomax. A-L-C-O-M-A-S. M-A-X. Alnico or alcomax. This material will be producing maximum flux density. So that's why the magnetic field will be produced due to permanent magnets which are made up of alnico or alcomax. The instrument in which frequency error is absent. Option A MC, option B MI, option C induction type instruments, option D dynamometer type. So in moving coil instrument, it is measuring DC quantities, that's why these frequency errors are absent. Option A, MC, moving coil type instrument. Okay, so this is the partial completion of today's class, working of PMMC meter. If you have any doubts, you can ask, or you can put that doubt size question in comment box, so that we will discuss in the next video lesson. Okay, thank you all of you for spending your valuable time in listening this video class. So today we will stop here. In the next class, we will discuss the moving iron type instruments. Moving iron type instruments are mainly two types, the attraction type and repulsion type. We will see the construction and working of those instruments, moving iron type instruments, in the next video lesson. Thank you all of you.